So the Warman competition has been running for about 27 years, and it requires undergraduate engineering students to design solutions to a simulated real-world problem. So this year, the task for the Warman competition was to develop two robots, one with an electrical control system and one purely mechanical. Now, the task was to take a payload, a simulated nuclear payload, lift it up a certain height, pass it to the mechanical-only robot, which would then use gravity to drive and stop within a certain region. This was Deakin's first involvement in the Warman competition, so we had to come up with a method for choosing a team which we believed would perform well. One team really stood out above the rest, and there was a team comprising of Bra, Daniel, Henry, and Nick.
Being a second year student, we didn't have much of knowledge or experience to actually build mechanical systems, so we were fortunate enough to get the rapid prototype technology here at Deakin, where we were trained to use laser cutters and 3D printers. 3D printers were used to make some components which were really hard geometrically to build.
Gears, wheel hubs, parts that had a complex geometries and difficult to make any other way.
Whereas laser cutters were cutting our scissor lifts, and a lot of the components are just laser cut.
We were able to export files from SolidWorks and come back the next day and you've got your beautiful components. That was always a lot of fun.
Our organising committee comprised myself and a technical officer, Damien Alderfield, and we were involved in both advertising the Warman competition to the students, recruiting them, and then mentoring them through the process.
One thing I would like to add is what Ben and Damien, both of them, did is gave us the flexibility to work on our own rather than telling us what to do, which made us learn a lot by research. And what they did is suggested us and advised us to just showed us the path rather than telling us what to do, which I loved about them.
It was quite exciting to see how the students progressed. So being able to, having that light bulb moment where, oh, that's what I was taught and that's how it's used in real life. That's how I can implement it. It's not just something that I learned that I haven't seen in practice. It's something that I learned, I applied, and I understand how it works, and I'm never going to forget. The competition itself was, as you'd expect, highly competitive and stressful. Many Australian universities were bringing their cream of the crop teams to perform.
So we rocked up at the competition. We were able to get some time on the test track.
Anecdotally, we were known as the team with one of the best fabricated and designed robots. So quality of the outcome was very high. The team came together and both runs were performed excellently. Deakin placed 6th out of 15, so it was a very good outcome. There were some teams that were ahead of the pack. The first and second teams were very good, but we did do exceptionally well. I think with a little bit more experience under our belt, we can do better next time. But look, it's not all about the place isn't everything. It's what students get out of the experience, and our students, I can say, have learnt a lot. Overall, the outcome was excellent. So I'm really looking forward to undertaking this again next year, and yeah, it was great.